Keepers of the Flame, I am with you once again. I am here, and I am in your heart, and my name is always Saint Germain. I come for the merit of the many and the few who throughout the ages to this hour have rallied round the cause of freedom. With me again is the goddess of freedom and my beloved Portia. Therefore, we find ourselves in good company in this cathedral that has been established in this place. Beloved ones, we come to see you and to see you off on your missions for the transmutation of a world. We come to deliver to you the alchemy of our hearts, that we might lighten your load and teach you indeed the way of the eternal Tao. So it is, beloved ones, that we are the Tao also, and we shall act through you if you will find that simplicity of being, even the waiting vestal virgin, as your souls are perfected in the light of the heart. Oh, the light of the heart. I therefore seal you in this moment, oh, all who are of merit, who have been a part of me for ages, with an amethyst heart, which I place over your heart chakra as a shield, aye, as a crystal, and as a transformer, that the love that you give and that you might give might be multiplied even by this focus of my heart, and that the love that you receive might also be multiplied for a more swift transmutation of every force of anti-love within and without your being, of all records of past ages and the rejection of God in the person of his archangels and angels and angelic messengers. Truly, your messengers come from the realms of angels, and they are your angelic messengers. And so you have indeed returned full circle, you who have attended this course, and all of those in the world of the root races who also share in a burden of karma that can become the burden of light and even the great leap from the place of yesteryear to the place of the future. Now, beloved, be seated with me in the eternal now. Now is the moment of the proverbial hourglass, and the hourglass is continually moving. The sands are falling. Perhaps you ought to own a little hourglass and place it on your desk and turn it now and then so that you can be reminded that the sands of your mortality are indeed running out. And if you do not displace your mortality with your immortality, then, beloved ones, what will you do when there are no more sands and you are sans opportunity? Yes, beloved, you will do what you have always done, perhaps. You will return to the scene of the wasted hours and moments and days, and perhaps then you shall enter into the fiery coil of ascension's flame. But for some of you, I say, beloved, the raw truth is that for you it is now or never. Not that you have failed, but that this is your hour of destiny, and I am your sponsor with the goddess of freedom and beloved Portia. And therefore you are sponsored to deliver your message to the nations. You are sponsored to realize the real self and presented to those near and far alike. You are sponsored, beloved, to be in this moment in time and space when millions of other souls in the earth need exactly what you have to offer from your causal bodies, from your hearts of devotion to freedom, and from all that you have learned and studied, and the cumulative awareness of the great white brotherhood that you now have awakened in this life, and yet you have known us for so very long. I come to embrace you, each and every one of you, for I rejoice, as does Lanello and El Moria, for these weeks we have shared together. Beloved ones, there is something very special about the summer of 1992. This has been a United Nations of the Spirit that shall not be divided by all types of chicanery that they have played at the UN. Yes, a spiritual United Nations, beloved ones, all bearing that point of the capstone that is theirs to embed in the capstone that you are placing not only upon the civilization America that I have sponsored, but also upon this church, universal and triumphant. It is a very special hour in the cycles turning. Therefore, seek and find the cycles of the astrology of the hour and the hours, for it is indeed a turning point. And I have told you, I am not finished with Pisces. I have not yet done with it. Therefore, you can expect me to appear in various places when least expected, for I intend to send my messenger in the year ahead, and I intend to send her where she must be myself in physical action, and can therefore provide you with my electronic presence, and you may be in polarity with that presence, and therefore work seeming wonders, but there are no real wonders for the Wonder Man of Europe, but only the scientific principle of the alchemy of God, the alchemistry of your own causal body that we may use to make all the difference. Turning of worlds it is, turning of worlds. Yes, your worlds have been turned, blessed ones. Now it is your turn to go out and turn many worlds. Keep them spinning, beloved, as the Elohim of God keep the planets in their courses. Think of the vastness of the cosmos, and that your own individual causal body may one day occupy more than the vastness of cosmos, but even the spiritual cosmos. Know then, beloved, that there is no turning back of you who are the determined ones and who have a heart, and therefore true hearts have come together, and you have come in the devotion to the five hearts, and you have understood profoundly, and therefore there is a depth and a breadth to your understanding. Now let it increase, and let there not be a cessation from your giving of yourselves to God. For as you experience the refinement of the Spirit, beloved, know that I can match that. Yes, beloved, I am yet in the business of securing grants from the Karmic Board and the Cosmic Council, and I have secured a grant, beloved. Therefore, I am very, very happy this day. You have been told that grants do not come easy to the ascended masters in this hour, and therefore it is considered a great boon by all of the Darjeeling Council, who are looking over my shoulder now, wondering what I will do with this grant. Well, I can assure you, beloved ones, from our experience in recent and past history, that I shall not so liberally dispense the energies and the backing that comes with the grant. But I want you to know that it is here, and it is here for those selected Chelas who themselves select to walk the path in an extraordinary devotion, and who would seek, having had the disciplines of El Moria and desiring to continue his disciplines, their own Chelaship with me. Yes, beloved ones, I desire to take certain of you on as my own Chelas, and this shall be, of course, by that merit. You understand, beloved, that the standards I hold must of necessity be high, for the very reason so implied that in the past, where I have not held to that level, many have misused my light and my coat and my cane. Yes, beloved ones, they have misused me, and I cannot allow it, for you see, the hour comes down to certain opportunities, and when the door does close, I can tell you it will swing shut, and no one, ascended or unascended, will be able to open that door. Therefore, I desire to see this grant stay and be replenished by those who receive a portion, multiply it, and multiply it again, and multiply it by the power of the ten, and return that just portion to me. Therefore, we shall be the apprentices of the great master alchemist of them all, the beloved, the one, the beautiful Lord Sanat Kumara. Yes, beloved, it is by the leave of Sanat Kumara that we stand here today, that there is a relative calm in the world, and that there is the opportunity for profound resolution and the spreading abroad of the teachings. Do not allow an hour or a day to pass that you are not concentrated in that creativity and the creative tension of divine love, whereby in your heart of fire, the fire may leap and contact those whom you know not, yet who will be drawn to your center, your study group, your place where you teach the little children and the older children. Yes, beloved, wherever you establish yourselves as servants of the people, I will bring certain ones to you. If there is not an established place, if two or three or five or ten or more do not gather and organize themselves to receive souls on a certain path, depending what it is you desire to do in your group, Then how shall I bring them? How shall I deliver them? How shall I give them the contact, not only with a teaching, but with one who can represent the teacher? Beloved hearts, it is important that you go forward in the name of your messengers, that you go forward in the name of the Brotherhood in White. It is important that people understand that there is a great tumult in the heavens, that the saints robed in white, who are the ascended brethren and sisters, are surely moving close in their support of the Queen of Angels, the Blessed Mary. It is important that people can identify themselves not only in the earth, but in the cosmic scheme of things, for thereby is the sense of confidence, the sense of relief, the sense that there is a divine order, and they are part of that order, and they can move up the rungs of the ladder of initiation as well as another, if they will also meet the requirements and understand the nature of initiation. Blessed hearts, do not minimize the capacity of the heart and the soul of the light bearer to understand the deep things of God. And yet, beloved ones, do not give too much, else it becomes simply an intellectual absorbing of facts rather than a true inner self-knowledge. I appeal to you then, and I tell you that I will have my angels robed in the miracle fire of the violet flame, who shall come to you, who shall teach you, who shall test you, who shall observe you, and who shall report back to me whether and when is the hour of the conceding of a grant, however small or great, to assist you. Therefore, beloved ones, top on our agenda is the sending of the messenger to you, for you have come to the mountain of God. Now the messenger would come to you. Thus it is a moment of preparation. It is a moment when we anticipate that we might deliver a tremendous message to the world, city by city. Therefore, I have come to you, beloved ones, and I ask your support for this divine plan, and I ask your assistance also to the teams who must go forth in advance of the messenger, even yourselves. Your support, then, of all that is required to make such a mission successful. I say to you, beloved ones, will you help me? In the hours and days ahead, therefore, keep the flame. Use your ingenuity and use our facilities and the preparations we have made for you to present the teachings. Above all, stay in tune with your heart. Retire to the secret chamber each evening and know then, as the sun sets where you are in the earth, and there does descend the peace of eventide, that the angels of Uriel and other bands make their evening journey around the earth and seal you in that resplendent light, even the golden pink glow ray, or the roseate, or the lavenders, or the lovely suffusing of that gold itself. Beloved ones, Look to the sun. Look to the sun of your I Am presence. Look to the central sun of life. I am Saint Germain. I place my cape upon you, those of you who have passed your tests and are worthy of receiving it. Thus the sign of the cape itself, beloved, and that particular focus that I place on the shoulder of each one. May you know what it is then, and how you are counted in the universities of the spirit and the etheric retreats, when you have passed through the halls of Summit University. Yes, beloved, your sponsorship for acceleration through clearance by Lord Gautama Buddha is one of the greatest, if not the greatest gift that is afforded the light bearers in the earth. It is worth all of the striving and all that it takes to arrive at Maitreya's Mystery School. May you press on now. May you become supremely practical. May you go to those places where you have served so magnificently. And may you be there, a pillar of fire by night and a cloud of witness, witnessing unto the Lord and the teachings and the messengers where you go. I commend you one and all who have striven to perform so mighty a work to achieve what you have achieved in your respective areas. Let all know that there is almost no limit to the capacity of the Chila, who knows the fire of the heart, who will pace himself and work directly with me. For I will be there, I will empower, and I will give my own graces. Within this 24-hour period, begun yesterday in this hour, you have begun to assimilate the graces that the Blessed Mother Mary has chosen to give to you. You have asked, and she has molded the gift to your deepest need and to the equation of the hour of your life stream. Forget not the inner resolution by the violet flame and by the joy of the heart. Forget not, beloved ones, the altar of God. O Abraham, 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 thou who didst go forth, thou who didst go forth, building the altar of God. Where the altar of God is, there is the opening unto heaven. There is my sponsorship with my son, Jesus, and all the sons and daughters of heaven and earth. Where you place the chart, where you place the image of our electronic presence, so, beloved, the pillar of fire descends and is strengthened by your devotion and regularity in service. Angels tend your altars, you tend them also. O beloved hearts, tend the altars of the children and youth and infants of the entire world. I am with you, Montessorians. I am with you, you who will carve out a new way of education. Let us break the barriers. Let us go marching out on the spokes of the giant wheel and reach them in every nation. Let us reach the hearts of the children. Ask me. Call to me, be steady, steady as the rock, beloved ones, steady as the rock, and you will see the increasing help that you will have from me. Plan wisely, build soundly, be cautious, respect all laws, do not cut corners, be frugal, and be certain that you have a business plan before you begin. This is no time for mistakes, mistakes costly to me and to you. This is the time to take advantage of the great pool of the Ascended Mastermind Alliance of all Ascended Masters and Chelas in embodiment. This is the time to know what you are doing and how you will do it before you put the shovel in the ground. I, therefore, am very interested in your projects. I am very interested in your endeavors, and I am interested in connecting your hearts by a strong cable to the hearts that must come out, that must be the called out ones, that must have the knowledge of the I am that I am before the year 2002 rolls around. Yes, beloved, they must be contacted. There is no alternative but to contact them and to do your outreach, for they are the very portion of those who should be here and who should be keeping their own altars where they are. The earth will be secure, beloved ones, the souls of light who contacted are contacted. If there be insecurity, relationship, white brotherhood, to those of you ascended, in that those who should be in your ranks, who are now embodiment, have got themselves mixed up for teachers, or into materialism, or in their karma, or whatever they have had that is led astray, and therefore they are not a part of these ones. Blessed ones, it behooves you to decree concerning those who call themselves the Cult Awareness Network. Their network is a network of darkness, and they, beloved ones, have determined that this messenger and you and this organization shall be decimated. They have no heart, beloved, and therefore it is important that you receive the labor for divine justice concerning those who have embodied the force of Din in the misuse of God's judgment as a vicious attack against the children of God. Let us overturn those who have perverted divine justice. Therefore, my beloved Portia stands before you as the divine mother of justice, to whom you may call and who has legions upon legions of the light of cosmic justice to deal with those in the earth who take the law into their own hands, turn inside out the law of God, and render false judgment, false accusation, false condemnation against those who are the servants of God. It is this problem that we must deal with. And when these forces are bound and put down, and for that, beloved Portia has earned her own dispensation, beloved, then you will see that there will be no stopping the light bearers and the security of those of us in higher octaves than you here shall be sealed. I promise you this, and I come to secure your promise that you will receive the labors on this, and you will act to perform them well. Now you have seen what a joy can come forth when mighty hearts of light determine to converge at the Royal Teton Ranch each summer for 8 weeks in the conference. Beloved hearts, you have seen what you can do, moving heaven and earth to come here and be a pillar of fire in the mountain of God. I give you my love, beloved hearts, for by your merit I have come. I say, go be the pillar of fire in your town and city and home, and turn this old world around for Saint Germain.